So make sure you watch this video all the way through because there is an important message. You know, it's really funny because over the years, and I do mean years, because the shit started when I worked at the Link. There have been a lot of just worthless dopes who have tried to do ridiculous things to somehow affect my situation, whether it be dealing at the Link, having a t-shirt that looked like that was like a play off the Starbucks logo, to filming my vlog at Bally's, at Planet Hollywood. And there have been people who have tried to affect my situation at the Westgate. It's actually ridiculous. You should have learned by now. Nothing has changed. Everything is exactly the same as it was 2 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago, 6 months ago, 5 years ago. Nothing has changed. You're a dope. You're a group of dopes. You should sit down and shut up because your attempts are absolutely futile. What up? It's the trooper with the Go Gamble Yeti. A legit Yeti mug that says Go Gamble on it. What? Trooper Thursday, y'all. The same Trooper Thursday that it has been for weeks, months, years. Believe me. Should we have a ceremony where I hand you the camera?
Well, I mean, it is traditional.
Don't move, Go Canucks Go. Don't do it. He's only a Canadian citizen.
No, I'm not even aggressive.
I actually had a plan for the video, which is something I don't have on Thursdays. And now that you are here,
the camera's who is you? That's me.
You people.
AKA you people.
You people from Canada.
Yeah,
you people. So now I hand the camera.
Can we have the official hand? Just one second.
To you. Any shout outs?
Oh, I got a couple shout outs. One is to my beautiful mother. I sit down, Sean, my buddy Sean White, a lot of shout outs. Conky, my buddy Brad, Diane, who's been here a couple of times.
Spencer?
Oh, little baby Spencer, yeah. But the shout outs that I was going to label tonight are on the list. Is Aaron and Liam. This is Trooper Thursday, and this is Trooper right here. He's the real thing, he's the real Neil Deal. And Dave and Carrie.
Are you sure he's real?
Come on, baby, give me a hug. So we don't
I can give him a hug. No,
we
kiss.
No,
I give him a hug.
There we go. Oh, he kissed him. He kissed my lips.
Yeah. We got Canadian Bill back in the house.
And you know what? Because of sponsorship, I gotta get this through. Sponsorship with Trooper, let's get this through. So I gotta change out of this jersey in about an hour because I want to make sure the sponsors. I gotta get a Trooper shirt on.
Got it.
Because it's sponsored by Go Gamble World, and I can't be in this for more than an hour.
All right.
By law, I'll get a phone.
And just to let everyone know who's watching, last Thursday, without either of us here, there were about 3 minutes of footage from the table. Today, I'm expecting like 3.5 hour video because you're going to have the camera most of the night.
It's funny because I actually had
a little footage.
I had a plan. I actually had a plan for the video, but I already started it, and here we are.
Why does he have that? I think it's just the introduction. It's all about introductions. He was carrying the sort of the drama here for about 6 weeks while I was gone.
I was carrying it.
Carrying you did?
It's been 6-8 weeks.
Bill Tate's a little rusty. He hasn't done this for a few months.
It's these technical.
He's missing some classic moments.
This is a classic. What do we have here now?
Perfect. Thanks, Mark.
What do we have here, Mark? What is that? Uncle Trooper?
If you know my coffee maker home, it's the Technivore Mocha Master. This is the Mocha Master filter holder, but it's special. Go Gamble.
Oh, that's beautiful. So what does it exactly do?
It just holds coffee filters.
So when I'm ready,
so 4 times a day, I walk over, I grab the filter, and then I use it. It's just a place to store them.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
I wasn't sure. Like, what?
Because you don't drink coffee.
I don't drink coffee.
You don't even know what a
coffee filter. When you say filter, I'm not sure what you're filtering. I assume you're filtering
paper filters. Paper. Paper filters.
Bill Tate's very rusty.
Oh man.
Okay, that's very nice. So how did he get the Go Gamble on it?
How did you get the Go Gamble on?
He's stealing his intellectual property.
Do you send it in and they take it? Yeah. Okay. It's a send in. Okay. To send in. So he sent it in, buys the product, sends it into a company. They make
it.
They
bought it and then I engraved it somewhere.
Yeah, somewhere around. Okay.
Situ misses you. Situ misses you.
Oh.
Situ, a nice good solution.
Now that Bill Tate's back, I'll say, hi, Situ. I know you watch my videos every day. Bill Tate tells me every chance he gets. I appreciate it, and I'm glad you enjoy it, even without having the poker background that Bill Tate has.
That's awesome.
Is it official yet?
Yeah, it's come early. Yeah, you go out there.
Thank you, Mark. I love that.
There you go. Here,
how much did that say?
Thanks, Juan.
See how my chips are delivered to me, Juan?
See them? Juan.
He said that's better.
Yeah.
I didn't get my car.
It's about right.
Nice to see you, Juan. Is it official yet?
Not until you press that.
You hear it, that. First call. It's now official.
It's official.
You're gonna have to do the flashy introduction. This is a new segment called, what are we calling it, Rice?
Trooper Trivia.
Is it Trooper Trivia or Trooper Thursday Trivia?
I feel like it needs to be
today
something
we'll
a little
be
more colorful.
Trivia. It becomes regular Trooper Thursday trivia.
Okay.
So I've been watching Trooper videos since day one, and I came up with 20 trivia questions. I want to know how well Trooper knows his own trivia.
Yeah.
So we're going to ask.
That'd be super trivia.
Yeah.
He knows it. Okay.
So first, I asked you.
First question is, am I going to be burping up these burritos all night long?
He needs a light on him. Like, I need some light.
I asked you four questions last week, and you got half of them.
Okay.
I asked, what types of people do they
lend to? Terrorists, sex offenders. That was two for two.
Oh, that counts as two questions?
Yeah.
Why not sex offenders? I don't understand.
Two reds, please.
Why not?
I'm not allowed.
I also asked what you paid in rent your first 2 months. You didn't get that correct.
It was $5.90.
Did you say how much did he pay when he ran himself out for the first time? I didn't hear you.
Oh, I know what it is now. 15, 16, 17, 10. Now 15, 10.
It was $5.70 a month.
What was the question? His first apartment?
How depressing
is that?
Yeah,
when he...
I paid almost 5 times that.
When he first moved into Desert Manor, what did he pay in his first 3 months in rent?
Four players.
It was $5.70 per month. But his first month was $100 off, so the total was $1,610.
Oh, it was only $100 off. I came up with $200 off, that's why.
What about the damage deposit? How much is that?
He didn't tell
Next
us
question,
camera.
How much?
I don't think there was one.
Could you damage Desert Manor?
Fine.
I don't know.
Alright, what's the next question? Holy shit, we're almost at the first commercial.
These are
I'm giving you an update on what you answered 2 weeks ago. You got the bed question right. You only told us one item you spent your money on from the bad beat you hit at the station casino on camera, and you got that correct, the bed. You told us some other things you did with the money, but only one item that you actually bought was a bed. You got that
correct. Do you say toys? I hear you say toys. I wasn't sure. I thought I heard selling toys.
Yeah. And we'll be back right after these ones.
We're going to cut to a commercial.
Hello, visiting from Ontario, Canada.
Shout out to
my husband, my family. Have a great day, man.
Hey, do you want to do a shout out back home, sir?
Shout out to the family, everyone back home.
Okay, any family have names? Any names like? Okay. It's the family that...
Canada.
It's not part of Canada?
What do you call it? Where do you live? Nova Scotia.
Nova Scotia, no. It's a different province.
Yeah. One of the
17 problems. Yeah, exactly. 10. I'm the camera guy that kind of came and built.
Yeah, I know. So, I know who you are.
I'm sort of a minor celebrity. Minor. You can't put it on camera. But at Trooper Thursday.
Trooper Thursday.
There you go. Go gamble.
Go gamble.
All best friends.
7 degrees of separation.
Oh, okay. It's Jason. Easy now. Easy Jason. What? Huh?
You say cut that out.
I don't say A. We don't say A.
I just did by it.
We think you guys say A. Here we are at the beautiful Westgate for the American Pool Association Championships, and it's Trooper Thursday, so lots of stuff going on. Here's what you're missing. Here's what you're missing, gang. Trooper Thursday, everybody's welcome. What happened to Canadian Bill? He dehydrated. Get it? He's not there in the seat. Star Trek, remember Star Trek? They were like doing their...
He's coming, he's gonna sit down. But this is what happened. Bill Tate left the room and we just noticed he was gone and the camera was gone and he went to change shirts because he's endorsed by Go Gamble.
Yes, Go Gamble brand. I can only do it for 2 hours and I gotta go.
And
I think it's
gonna
be funny, but you really... No, I'm not trying to make it funny, I'm just telling the truth.
Today when Trooper goes home, he's gonna see all the footage from the bathroom that no one has ever seen yet. So that's the part that we're waiting for. How many minutes did you film in the bathroom?
Oh, he'll see when the camera... Nice sneakers. You're gonna have some surprise footage. You got some surprise.
We are having an extra fun Trooper Thursday. What with the return of Canada Bill. Thursdays can be a pretty constant reminder of why I do and should do this vlog. Lots of people come through, say hello. Some play in the game, some don't. Pretty much every Thursday, there are people that come through the room just to say hello. People come from the Strip. They make their way all the way over here to the Westgate just to hang out for 10 minutes and chit-chat, say hello, see everything, see Trooper Thursday, see myself, see Canada Bill, El Diesel, all the people who are usually here. Some people tell me it's like a TV set because it's something they watch on their TV all the time and then they show up, you get the picture. And it's fun and I enjoy it. I'll never get over people treating me as though I'm some sort of celebrity because, not because I love it so much, but because I disagree. I don't think I'm a celebrity at all, you know? And I'm just a dude who came to Vegas to play poker, make YouTube videos, and there you go, right? But I appreciate it, and I appreciate everyone coming by, and I appreciate everyone watching the videos. And when I feel like I want to quit, because everyone probably feels that way at some point or another, there are a few things that happen, that have happened, that give me a really good reason to carry on. One example was months ago now, I usually let time go by before I reference anything like this because I don't want to tell anyone's personal business on YouTube, but a guy came to Trooper Thursday quite a few months ago and he told me, at the end of the night, he told me that my videos, he told me that he had been an alcoholic and that he had quit drinking, and it had been so many months since he had last had a drink, and he said that my videos helped him do that. And of course, I mean, other than the fact that I just don't drink, I mean, I don't know how my videos could have an impact on someone's, you know, journey to quit drinking or to stop being addicted to anything. And he told me that it was basically my attitude
of not giving a shit what anyone else thinks. His biggest roadblock when it comes to quitting alcohol, it was peer pressure. If all your friends, if all your coworkers, if all the people you associate with drink on a regular basis, then I can see how it will be difficult to stop doing that, because as shitty as it may sound, if you do stop drinking and you're with and all your friends drink and you've been drinking with them for years, and co-workers and family and everyone else, they can turn on you. You know what I mean? People can be like, well, who are you to quit drinking? Who are you to do better for yourself? And I kind of know where that comes from. Wow, that lady has the most purple hair that I've ever seen. So anyway, I don't know. That's pretty much the whole story. I appreciate that. I appreciate that someone can get that from my videos, that someone could say, well, Trooper doesn't give a shit what people think about, you know, the way he does things. Like, I used to sort of like keep my OCD shit sort of on the down low, if you will. But now I just whip out the phone with the Ziploc bag at Trooper Thursday, and when someone asks me why in the hell is my phone in a bag, I just say it's a long story and it's a Go Gamble phone condom. I don't know. I don't just talk about it, I be about it. Wait a minute, is that right? Is that how you would say it? I don't know. I basically, if I'm not gonna give a shit what anybody thinks, then I don't give a shit what anybody thinks. And that's why in the history of my vlog, I put my bed in the living room and the TV and the couch in the bedroom. Why? Why did I do that? Ask yourself, why did I do that? And why did I show it on video?
How many generations of fans are here?
Two generations.
Okay, two generations, okay.
We've been watching for the past, 6 months?
Uh-huh.
That's it.
Oh, yeah, we're big fans, though. Every day for the past 6 months.
And we listen to podcasts, too, so. Uh-huh.
That's a pathetic excuse. Really pathetic, I know.
And we were interested in the Feathers weight gain or weight loss.
Well, to be fair, we thought it would be fun and interesting from the beginning, but as you said, we got pretty cool.
Yeah. Yeah.
We're hoping to get his picks tonight.
Yeah.
Oh, no, oh right. Now? He's part of the Green Lock Jets.
There's no football going, right?
The Jets are playing right now.
They're in the bed. Oh, yeah, it's a Hall of Fame game.
Oh, right there.
Who lives in Vegas here? Do you want to, your name is?
Barb.
Barb, do you want to do a shout out, Barb? Back home?
Shout out to Carly and Jack.
Carly and Jack.
Okay. Hello, Carly and Jack. Okay.
John.
Yeah. Carly and John. Carly and John, okay. I noticed an accent. Where are you from?
Chicago.
Oh, Chicago. There's a Chicago accent.
That's
okay.
Not an accent.
I'm Canadian Bill. I'm from Flint, Michigan. I mean, yeah.
So you get a double espresso at Starbucks in your office.
Oh, isn't that nice?
You couldn't find better espresso somewhere.
Starbucks
is
pretty good.
Was it? I believe it.
Wait, it was good, yeah.
Three generations of love right there, Trooper.
Thank you.
Okay. Thanks for coming over.
Yeah, thank you.
Ooh, look at that for a flop.
What kind of content is this, Bill?
I'm just trying to just create content. It's volume. I'm trying to get volume over...
So he has to watch for 8 hours?
No, he just... This stuff, you know what? This blends right in. It's like, it's seamless. It's called seamless video photography. Okay, here we go, Sam.
My first shout out is to Chuck Lineberry at Rounders Card Club in San Antonio, Texas. You the man, Chuck.
Appreciate it.
I also have a shout out to Robert, and you know who you are, buddy. I hope you're doing well, and we'll talk soon.
Beautiful.
That's all.
Thank you, Sam. Appreciate it.
I'm usually cold in here.
A cab driver in Tokyo.
Hitoshi, remember?
Oh, Hitoshi, he sits right side here.
His name, we can't think of him.
I know.
Yeah, he is. He is a tax driver.
He lives in Tokyo, too.
Oh, really? What part of Tokyo?
15, the Japanese part. He lives in Tokyo.
Tune in Tokyo.
The Japanese part.
I live in Tokyo.
You live in Tokyo?
Yeah. You gotta take a bag.
What part, where you live? In,
Shinji.
Shinji, okay, I know well.
You gotta take
is that by, is that by Oskosa?
He responded.
Let's have a look.
Oh, I'm not in on that.
Did you ever hear the one about the guy that came in the desert and get off the horse and pick the horse up and kiss his ass? The guy rode in the desert, get off the horse, pick the tail and kiss his right in the ass? Oh, heard that story? He did, it happened. Went into a bar and the guy said, I've been working in this bar for 30 years. I never saw a guy ever get off a horse, pick a tail and kiss him right square in the asshole. Why'd you do it? The guy says, chapped lips. Chapped lips. Does that cure chapped lips? He says, I don't know if it cures chapped lips, but it stops you from licking them. That's a San Antonio type of story. Yeah, that's a good one. Mike understands that one. That's a good one.
Mike's a Texan.
Sit down, Bill.
I can't. I have a job to do. I'm here for a reason.
Well, Trooper was just telling this story, which is going on for like 45 minutes. So I'm just like,
yeah. Is this going to be a long story?
It's only like a third over. It's been like 20 minutes. Except for this. The question was, why does Trooper have his phone in a Ziploc bag? And somehow the answer was like 65,000 words.
You asked him on Tuesday.
これは人下へのメッセージです。ブログを見たら、じゃあ連絡しよう。じゃあまたね、よろしく。
Hitoshi, two people in Tokyo watched the vlog. You and Steve.
ブログ見てますよ。
Thank you.
じゃあまた。
Thank you, Steve. How do you say Japanese? Thank you. What do you say Japanese? Thank you.
Domo arigato.
Domo arigato, Mr. Roboto.
What did you do in Japan, Bill?
Hey, Shaft and Angie.
How's it going?
Shoutouts.
Quick shout out to our little guy Cameron, who's home with my grandma.
How old's Cameron?
My mom. 12.
Does he watch Trooper?
Yeah. Yes. He watches it with me. He watches Christina too.
Yep. Oh, really? Cameron, you know who this is?
What?
He said hi to Cameron.
Hi, Cameron.
Cameron.
He met Cameron last year.
Cameron, okay. Yep. Thanks, guys. Thanks for showing up. Okay, appreciate it.
I'm camera shy.
He is camera shy.
So at the end of it all, the real point is, don't worry about what other people think. I used to worry way more about what people thought than I ever should have. And if I really worried about what people thought, who knows if I would have even continued vlogging or doing anything that I do. Because believe me, when you start putting your life out on YouTube, there are going to be a lot of people with a lot of shitty opinions about every little fucking thing that you do. So the moral of the story today is, don't give a damn what people think. There may be a few people who you respect, whose opinions you can respect, but when it comes to the right thing to do with your life, don't listen to the bullshit. I've been thinking a lot about the bomb pot tournament that we're having here on Thursdays, and I am about 98% decided that I'm gonna stop playing the tournament. The original intent of the tournament was to, you know, just do something new for Trooper Thursday and try to pump it up a little bit. But in the end, it really just sort of like hinders the start time of Trooper Thursday. The tournament will be continuing at 1 p.m., but I'm not sure that I'm going to be playing it. I'm going to be showing up here at 4 p.m. It makes a really long day. Starting the tournament at 1 p.m. and playing Trooper Thursday until midnight is a really long day, so I'm not really sure I'm going to continue to play the tournament. So Trooper Thursday will stick with its official start time of 4 p.m. from here on out. And remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. I'm going to see you next time.